Sydney. It's still dark outside. It's about 6:15 in the morning. Today's the day we're going on the truck run, hauling the Hume down to Yass. We had about 10 tins of beer last night while we were getting everything ready, and we decided that there's an empty trailer, so we might try and throw the old DCF 400 here on. It hasn't been started in years, so it's probably going to be a bit of a rushed start, but it's all we can do if we want to take it. And I didn't want to do another bodgy start later on, because she's all we've seen on the trailer. So. Put two big batteries in. It hasn't been going for years. I've had the injectors out to try and diagnose a miss in the 671 I've got in the white. I can't remember if it's run since, but we'll soon see. It's only got a run to drive out of the shed and up on the ramps. Take it. I want to take it and show it off because they're a rare sight in Australia. It's a 1969 International DCF 400. I think it's 69. I don't know a lot about it, so anyone that does, please comment. It's got a 8V71 in it, 15-speed overdrive, Hendrickson walking beam, and it's got 44,000-pound Eatons under it. I'll do a quick walk around before we start her up, before we try anyway. I've had this truck for years, and I don't intend doing it up at the moment. I'd like to get some more time. This is where I'd like to grow the channel for. And once I become full time, if that ever happens, that's only a dream at the moment. But these are the sort of things I'll be restoring. I'd love to get it on the road, but it's going to take a lot of Saturdays, if that is the case. But I bought it off a mate of mine. I'd like to do a tour of his place one day. He's got the most amazing collection I've ever seen of mainly tractors, just unique vehicles. I'll do a bit of a change of mode on the camera here. So she's heavy spec, it's dual rail right through, only short. Must have been doing some sort of heavy work. Slow geared, Hendrickson walking beam, all that's fairly tight. Well, chassis a bit rough in spots, but nothing we can't fix. If I did it, I'd pull all the suspension out and split the rails and do it properly. The old cabs looks rusty, but it's not right through, so she's got a lot of nicky in her, bong. That surface rust there is fine, as long as it's not all the way through, which most of it's not. It's in pretty good order, really. It's got a lot of dings, but nothing we can't handle. I don't want to paint it. I like the original look, but I think she may be a bit too far gone, especially with something like that missing out of the door, unless I can replicate that somehow. This side's fairly the same. Square fuel tank on this side. I'd love another one of those to match the other side. Look beautiful, these big old tanks. Again, got hydraulics on it, PTO. Got that box there. You know, I don't think I've ever opened that. Could be anything in there. But she's fairly unique. Probably a lot around, but you just don't see them. I doubt there is. It's got that muffler there. It's got a straight through piece of pipe pushed down through it, but it's still very, very quiet. Something about the two Transtars I've got with 871s in them are both quiet. Both straight throughs. Like when I say straight through, the mufflers haven't got much baffle in them, and you still can't hear them. The old white there and the two Kenworths are just very, very noisy, but this old girl's just doesn't seem to be, so don't know why that is. So we're going to put some big batteries in. I'll throw the bonnet over, just see if she goes before we start moving all the stuff out in front of it. Yeah. Thank you.
You want to look the batteries up and put this on?
Yeah. Okay, here she is, the mighty 8B71. I don't know what they're rated. The standard rating for these is about 318, but probably the earlier ones, I think they're a bit less. Depends on the injectors, probably 290 in this one. Cover off because it's been a while, and see if the rack wants to play. Fairly early issue, might not mind waking up like us.
Well, I don't either, but she deserves to come out for the weekend.
Well, it's not tuned very well, it's got no park brake, it's got no foot brake, so we can get her out of the shed. She is loose. Probably not as loose as I'd like, but anyway, it needs a tune, which I can do later. I might just throw some bi-scripts handy so I can kill her if that's the case. While I've got this going, I'll show you inside. It's like a bloody old submarine in here in World War One. Look at that. Complete with the old redbacks for it. For another look, this one of them baby bastards, fucking Brown, King Browns here, look. Someone snuck a quick one into it. So look at that old seat. Look at the suspension on that thing, Jesus. That's them hard-working blokes who used to do bloody 14 hours in these things. Longer. Sleep in them and everything. Beauty. Okay, put some batteries in, see what she does. She mightn't want to come with us, we'll see. Control it if she takes off. You can't stall this one because the maxis don't work. Might even get you to hit the button, Mick, and I'll just control it. Just Sit tight for a bit, Mick. I'll just put some water in her. No brakes. Just give her a go, Mick. I'll see if they... Hang on. Standard Steve's place, fucking battery terminals. Alright. Front of her. No, I turned it off, Mick. Yeah, yeah. I'll drag this pallet out from underneath it and set your truck up. You can hear the air scraping out of her. I should just do a bit of work at a treadle valve and get all the brake valves working on it. Make it a bit safer. You can hear something going on in there. It wants to come anyway, so I'll set these other trucks up, drop the ramps and run her on, and it'll be time to go in a minute. Alright everyone, here we go. She's got no brakes. Just gonna start her up, don't have to build any air up and just into it. So you get one of it moving to start with and then one I'll set it up again to load it.
No brakes, Mick. Don't walk anywhere near it.
Yeah, you've got to go heaps over your way, mate.
Staying home.